In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, Father.
Welcome to this Mass in honour of St. Peter and Paul, Apostles. There's always a feeling of Founders' Day when we celebrate Peter and Paul. Because without their generosity, without their faith, without their witness, we would not be gathered here this morning celebrating the faith that has come to us from the Apostles. Let us ask their prayer and their intercession as we say thanks to God for them. Lord, as we gather as your people, steeped in the faith of Peter and Paul, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
As we gather to listen to your word, Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
As we are fed with your own body and blood, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant, Lord our God, that we may be sustained by the intercession of the Apostles Peter and Paul, that as through them you gave your church the foundations of a heavenly office, so through them you may help us to eternal salvation. And we make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Today's first reading is from the Acts of the Apostles, and tells the story of Peter's miraculous escape from prison. And the typical of Peter, at the end of it, he wakes up in a street somewhere in a dwelling, thinking the whole thing has been a dream. In the second reading, Paul writing to Timothy explains that he too has been rescued by God for a purpose, the purpose of preaching the word.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. King Herod started persecuting certain members of the church. He beheaded James, the brother of John, and when he saw that this pleased the Jews, he decided to arrest Peter as well. This was during the days of unleavened bread, and he put Peter in prison, assigning four squads of four soldiers, each to guard him in turn. Herod meant to try Peter in public after the end of the Passover week. All the time Peter was under guard, the church prayed to God for him unwittingly. On the night before Herod was to try him, Peter was sleeping between two soldiers, fastened with double chains, while guards kept watch at the main entrance to the prison. Then, suddenly, the angel of the Lord stood there, and the cell was filled with light. He tapped Peter on the side and woke him. "Get up," he said, "hurry." And the chains fell from his hands. The angel then said, "Put on your belt and sandals." After he had done this, the angel next said, "Wrap your cloak around you and follow me." Peter followed him, but had no idea what the angel did was all happening in reality. He thought he was seeing a vision. They passed through two guard posts, one after the other, and reached the iron gate leading to the city. This opened of its own accord. They went through it and had walked the whole length of one street when suddenly the angel left him. It was only then that Peter came to himself. "Now I know it is all true," he said. "The Lord from the second letter of St. Paul to Timothy. My life is already being poured away as a libation, and the time has come for me to be gone. I have fought the good fight to the end. I have run the race to the finish. I have kept the faith. All that is to come now is the crown of righteousness reserved for me, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will give to me on that day. And not only to me, but to all those who have longed for his appearing. The Lord stood by me and gave me power, so that through me the whole message might be proclaimed for all the pagans to hear. And so I was rescued from the lion's mouth. The Lord will rescue me from all evil attempts on me and bring me safely to his heavenly kingdom. To him be glory forever and ever. Amen. Whatever you bind on earth shall be considered bound in heaven. Whatever you loose on earth shall be considered loosed in heaven. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Watson and Holmes, Rosemary and Thyme, Vera and Joe Ashworth, Morse and Lewis, Lewis and Hathaway, and even the detective Father Brown has an alter ego. pairings. They always complement each other, making up in each other for the personal lackings. Peter and Paul are exactly the same. Paul was eloquent, a great communicator, clever, witty, funny. He had travelled the world. He had been taught by the finest minds of the age. He was self-assured, confident, and daring. Peter was shy and humble and genuine, a bit hot-headed, had never left Galilee until he went to Rome, was a bit overwhelmed at being asked to front this new project by Jesus. If our founding father was Paul alone, then we might be put off by his arrogance. If it was Peter alone, we might think that this whole project is only for those of simple minds. But God very cleverly has arranged that both complement each other, and at the beginning, both were needed for the church's success. Who do you most identify with, Peter or Paul? Because you will be one or the other, and both are needed for our parishes to succeed. We need the confidence of those who volunteer quickly. We need the intellectuals. We need the quiet background workers, the prayers, the financially supported. We need everyone to understand that they complement each other. And we need have no jealousy or fear of the other. Everyone, every type is needed to build a successful project for God. We ask Peter and Paul to pray with us.
For Pope Francis, the successor of Peter, may his openness and wisdom continue to strengthen the church. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For missionaries, like Paul, may they form new communities of faith. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For those in our parish who pour out their lives for the sake of our community. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For ourselves, that our union with Christ may be the foundation of our solidarity as a parish family. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For Ellen Grant, who was buried last week, enjoy life with the angels and with the saints. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us. Father, hear our prayer, and like Peter and Paul, form us in rock-like faith, in unquestioning love, and in heartfelt repentance. And we make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God and Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
May the prayers of the apostles, Lord, accompany these gifts that we present to you for consecration, and may their intercession make us devoted to you. And we make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For by your providence, the apostles Peter and Paul bring us joy. Peter, foremost, in confessing the faith, Paul, its outstanding preacher, Peter, who established the early church from the remnant of Israel, and Paul, master and teacher of the Gentiles. And so each in a different way gather together the one family of Christ and are revealed together throughout the world as they share one martyr's crown. And therefore, with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, hosanna, hosanna. the mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
Father, celebrating the memorial of the death and resurrection of your Son, who left us this pledge of his love, we offer you, which you first gave to us, this sacrifice of reconciliation. We ask you, Father, to accept us together with your Son, and in this saving banquet, fill us with his Spirit. May he make each member of your church a sign of unity, a champion of justice, and an instrument of your peace. And may he keep us all in communion with Francis, our Pope, Philip, our own bishop, all the bishops, and your entire people. Just as you have gathered us now around the table of your Son, so also bring us together with the glorious Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, her husband Joseph, the apostles and all the saints, and with our brothers and sisters, and those of every race and tongue who have died in your friendship. Bring us to share with them the unending banquet of unity in a new heaven and a new earth, where the fullness of your peace will shine forth in Christ Jesus, our Lord.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, the mighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen.
We ask Peter and Paul to pray with us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin and safe from all distress as we wait in joyful hope the return of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on our faith, and grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Grant us, Lord, that we have been renewed by this sacrament, so as to live in the church, that persevering in the breaking of bread and in the teaching of the apostles, we may be of one heart and one soul, and made steadfast in your love. And we make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. There will be no Zoom cafe this morning because of exposition, which will take place in both churches at 11 o'clock till noon. Because of the ticketing, I know the second part is full this morning. So if you're deciding now to go, could you please go to St. Lucy's, where there will be room there. Kenny, our deacon, was ordained 11 years ago today, so if you give him a clap just now in the house, we'll probably hear it down here. And